lead there in the other half of the draw. Favourites will be Chou Tien Chen against Lo Kuen Yew in the final. We shall see.
On court one, men single, Mark Hoyo, Netherlands.
Well, these two have met only once before, and that was coming up to almost 4 years ago, Chou Tien Chen winning that one in straight games. And he was probably at the height of his powers. So Mark Caljouw is just over 6 foot. He's currently 51st in the world. Has been a little bit higher than that. This is a big ask for him. He's only played players have been promoted from qualifiers so far. Hasn't dropped a game up till now. Chou Tien Chen is 34, a bit shorter at 180. 14th in the world right now. His blank ranking has dropped quite considerably. And he is, of course, a former world number two. Got to the world champs last 2 years ago and finished third. Silver medal at the Asian Games in 2018. Asian Championships in 2019, he was third as well. Now, he has dropped games against Wang Po Wei as a qualifier, and then Lin Chun Yu as a defending champion. Now, he's only played Chinese Taipei opponents so far. He's won 8 titles on the World Tour. Last year, he won the Hilo Open. He was also a runner-up at the Swiss Open. Chiaki Miyazaki is our umpire for this one. Umpire Asing Samanan is our Thai service judge.
Ready to play.
We're looking at Mark Caljouw, who was 23rd, his highest ranking, in August 2021. Former European junior runner-up in 2013. He has won one title on the World Tour, that was the Orleans Masters in 2018. Last year, he was a runner-up at the Abu Dhabi Masters. There's no doubt that Chou Tien Chen will be the big favorite here.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Mark Caljouw, Netherlands. And on my left, Chou Tien Chen, Chinese Taipei.
No doubt as to who the big favorite is here for this one.
Level play.
Oh, that made it in. That looked like it was going to go out. Love. Whether that is the faster end. Well, this is an excellent start from Caljouw. And the Dutchman is now 3 points to the good at the moment. First point on the board then for Chou Tien Chen. Yeah, just too much on that from Chou. He packs quite a punch, hasn't he? Now he takes the lead. That's four in a row. There's famously doesn't have a trainer. Chou Tien Chen is Victoria Cow. This has been pretty tight so far. Last year, Chou Tien Chen won 29, lost 22. This year, he's not a very good start. Opening round of the Malaysia Open, he lost to Thomas Junior Popov. Opening round to Pranoy in India Open. Got to the second round of the Indonesia Masters, lost to Kunlavut Vititsan.
Six, four.
So this is, I'm sure, big relief to him that he's a He's gone deep in this tournament. Remember, Olympic qualification also, I'm sure, foremost on his mind.
7-4.
His last semi-final was the Kumamoto Masters in November last year. We lost to Shiyu Chi, who eventually won it.
8-4.
Now there's a 4-point lead here. Just got that ankle a little bit strapped up there, you can see the left ankle of Mark Caljouw, and you can feel as well that Chou Tien Chen is getting into a stride now. Bit better here from Caljouw. Just clips the net. Nicely constructed by Caljouw, looking to get on the offensive here.
Nine.
In theory, as we said, world number 14 versus the world number 51. Someone who's also beaten Caljouw before, you would think that Chou Tien Chen comes in very, very much the favorite. But it's Caljouw who's bouncing back quite nicely. He's putting on a run. Four in a row. He looked to be in a very good position, Chou Tien Chen. Very low down for him, wasn't it? This has been excellent from the Dutchman. Five in a row here. He was in some trouble at 9-4. Victoria Cao, you might have just heard there. They're encouraging Chou Tien Chen. first one. He has no issues putting away. Not really much more he could do there.
Thank you.
This has been very decent actually so far. His coach would be quite happy with this. Caljouw. Better from Chou Tien Chen. Takes us to the interval. And it's 11-9 in game one. It's a bit more like it from Chou Tien Chen. Who's now won three in a row.
Thank you.
So last year, 29 wins, 24 defeats on the World Tour. Sort of semi-decent ending to the year, but then, as we said, this start of this year was not great. That looked quite a precise shot. Caljouw is challenging that. I think that's fair enough, that one, to challenge. Oh, it's very much in. As I said, that power from Chou Tien Chen is very difficult to deal with. 5 seems to get to about something like a 5-point lead. Caljouw suddenly perks up again. And then look at that. He's done that a number of times, actually.
16-11.
Oh, like he's been fed those sort of shots. Got to be careful of doing that.
Thank you.
Oh, lovely. From Caljouw, great.
Top cover.
Reflexes. Here, wonderful adjustment made by him. Actually, Caljouw leading at the moment, 9-7. Oh, I'll make that 9-8 now, but since he was 4-9 down.
17-30.
Sorry, it's 8-all, I should say, excuse me. Oh, 9-8. No, that's in, that's good. Just keeping himself there in the mix.
14-17.
It's hard to say, which is, we've not had any match go to three so far today. Been a mixed bag as to who has started at this closer end, which goes minimally against the drift.
Sun cover, 18-14.
There's that 5-point cushion that he normally has, which Caljouw generally fights back from, but he needs to do that now. And this time he can't. And this is the biggest lead we have seen. Oh, he's taken on that flick serve very well indeed, Caljouw. Five game points still. So Chou Tien Chen wraps up the first game. Caljouw had some decent moments in there, including a big, big fight back, where he got it up to 9-all from being 4-9 down. But after that, from that point on, actually, Chou Tien Chen never looked back when he took the lead again. So Chou Tien Chen wins the first game, 21-15 rather.
Where's the board? Second game. Level. Play.
So, Mark Caljouw now on that far end, the so-called faster one. See if that suits him a bit better. He's been looking to try and take the game to his opponent.
Stand cover. One, all.
As we saw in the previous game, the first few points, especially as they both get used to it now on this new end for each of them, will be maybe a little bit tight. And then Chou Tien Chen just started surging, didn't he?
Three, two.
He is the only non-Asian in the semi-finals today. Mark Caljouw. A big moment, of course, for someone like him. Sure, he's looking to get back into being inside the top 20, 25. Not easy, of course. Looking, of course, for Olympic qualification as well.
Out.
Stand cover. 4-3.
Yeah, so as I said, on that end, he will look to attack. As well from the Turakau, despite Chou Tien Chen losing the point. Oh, it's out. He had him on the ropes there, Caljouw.
8-5.
Oh, that's got to be frustrating. That was close to clipping the line, wasn't it? confident play there from Chou Tien Chen, who, when you look at his record last year, of course, he made three semifinals, won two of the three. Absolutely hammered that back. And in his career, in terms of semifinals, there's a lot. 36 wins, 22 losses at semi-final level. That's 58 semi-finals he's been in. He's won four of his last five. And at the interval here of the second game, he is cruising here at 11-5, Chou Tien Chen. The only semi-final he went in last year, Caljouw, was at the Abu Dhabi Masters, where he beat Kieran George to get to the final, which he eventually lost to Mads Christoffersen. In his career, generally, four semi-finals on the World Tour, he's been to 11, he's won four of those 11. Fine run to the All England in 2021, where he got all the way to the semi-finals, only to lose it to eventual winner Li Zijia. Chou Tien Chen a taste of his own medicine. Again, he's getting challenged, shaking the head. Well, I think he's too convinced by that, and that is probably not going to go his way. There's that drift not working in his favour. Well out that one.
One challenge remaining. Time's over. 13-7. Play. Time's over.
14-8. Yeah, they like that one. You have to go back a long, long way to see when Chou Tien Chen was ranked this low down. They enjoyed that.
Back cover.
Right into his stomach. It's all smiles.
15.
Having good fun with that. Yeah, he's missed that one, isn't he? Yeah, just start to
69.
Complete my point. We're talking about August of 2014 when he was this, or he was lower than the 14th in the world that he is now. That's when he was 17th in the world, competing at the World Champs. When he got to the quarterfinals. That was the last time he was right this low. That is incredible. 10 years ago. He is 34 now. That's how long he's been at the top of his game. Not long after that, he got into the top 10.
18.
By
nine.
October of 2014, and then he's never really looked back. Until he dropped out of top 10 last year. Not far away now.
Thank you.
To show his dominance, Chou Tien Chen, the last person he lost to who was ranked outside the top 50, which is what Caljouw is, was 60th ranked person called Li Zijia at the Taipei Open in 2018. Lost in three, his home tournament as well. That's going to sting. He also lost to a 125th Cao Junpeng in the Macau Open in 2016. That time he was eighth in the world.
11.
And he lost to Li Zijia, he was fourth in the world. Little flourish here from Caljouw.
12-19.
And for his part, Caljouw, let's see when he has beaten a top 20. So 5 wins and 39 against top 20 players. His last win was against Sai Pranit at the World Champs in 2021. He beat him in three in the first round. He was 16th in the world then. But he will not achieve a giant killing act today. It is Chou Tien Chen who is into the final here. He's popular. His first final since the Hilo Open towards the end of last year. His third final since 2023, or in 2023 and 2024. Less and less these days, but he will be delighted with that. And it was pretty comfortable, wasn't it, overall for Chou Tien Chen. He did a great job here. Well, thank you there from Chou. And he waits now to see who he plays in the final. A facile win, you'd have to say. Chou Tien Chen beats Mark Caljouw. 21-15, 21-12. It's taken him just 33 minutes to do it. Well, it's been all straight games wins so far. And semi-final day here of the HSBC BWF Thailand Masters 2024. We're into our sixth match of the day. It's mixed doubles and a big one here for the Thai fans. Dechapon, Puavuran and Kroen.